Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you network address translation. See, network address translation means here with given LAN, there will be private IPs only. There will be private IPs only, right? And here router will be converting those private IPs into public IP for internet communication. In my last video, I have explained you the meaning. I have explained you the meaning of private IP and public IP, right? And for internet communication, like see, this LAN can communicate on the internet, but that is possible via public IP only. So this router will have to convert this private IP into public IP for outgoing frames, and for incoming frames from internet, this router will convert public IP into private IP. Let me show you an example on my computer, so that will give you more clarity. See, for that I need to take you to my computer screen. And see, in command window, if you write ipconfig, then you will be observing what is your private IP. So this is my private IP, 192.168.0.103. This is my private IP. And on Google, if I write what is my IP, so Google is saying this is my public IP. So by this public IP, I am communicating on internet, right? Now, if you observe my Wireshark software, so in Wireshark software, if you observe, you see, this is my private IP. This is my private IP, you see, this is my private IP, and this is my router's IP, right? So if you observe here, all the communication that is translated by router, you see, router to my and my to router. See, this is how things are happening, right? Translation is happening like this. And practically communication is happening via public IP, but here public IP will not be given. The reason is here source and destination, that is my device and router device, right? Now let me show you how it is happening. So here you see, this is my device, right? This is router. So obviously router will be having its IP. So here you will be observing in software, your IP to router IP frames will be there. But practically with internet, there will be public IP via which there will be communication, right? With the use of private IP, we cannot communicate on internet. So how it happens? Let me show you that. See, for example, as if I say, this is my computer, and on this computer, I'm writing www.google.com. If I write this, then obviously Google server that is there on the internet, so directly with this IP I cannot communicate. So what I need to do, I need to send this request to router. Now let us say this google.com, that is having destination IP, that is this. So here with the frame here destination IP will be given, and that destination IP will be 25.10.5.8. You see, this is the destination IP with which I'll be forwarding frame to router. Now what router will do, you see, router will replace my IP with public IP, that is this. My IP is this, and that will be replaced by in public IP, right? So this is what the case which is router is doing right now. Router is observing this is out frame from this host. As this is out frame from this host, so it will be giving it to internet. So before it sends it to internet, what it does is it will be replacing my private IP with public IP over here. So you can observe here, it is replacing it over here. And destination IP will be this only, which is the IP which is there with respect to Google, right? Now what will happen? This frame will go to Google. Now let us say Google is replying back. So when Google replies back, at that time source IP will be this, which is there from Google. So here we were been having Google, www.google.com, and that is having what IP? Now it will be having source address, and that is as per this IP only 25.10.5.8. Now it will be sending frame in this direction. It will be sending frame in this direction. So this will be inward frame. So now this router will recognize, okay, the one who have asked request with this destination IP, now that is replying back. But Google will be replying to public IP only. You see, Google will be replying to public IP only. Now see, this public IP, that is this which is coming at this router. So now this router will do what? This router will replace this public IP to private IP. You see, by network address translation, it will replace this by private IP. So now it is replacing it by private IP. So here frame will come. So here frame will come, right? So here this router job is what? This router job, that is to translate public IP to private IP, private IP to public IP, and that it done, that it does by having table. So in table there will be entries, and based on entries it will replace it. So there can be two types of way by which it can replace. One is simply by having entries with respect to IP, and second is by having port address, right? So to understand how many types of network address translations are there, then in general there are three categories of network address translation. You see, first one is static NAT. NAT means network address translation. So in static NAT, one-to-one mapping is established between private and public IP addresses. It is typically used when internal device needs to have fixed public IP address. So here you see, this device is having, let us say, only one public IP, and here only one-to-one translation is happening. In that case, static NAT will be there. But when it comes to dynamic NAT, in that you see, there will be pool of public IP address. Pool of public IP address means there will be multiple public IP address. See, obviously if you have so many devices over here, then there can be multiple public IP addresses over here, right? For example, if I say here we are having one college, they are having 1000 computers. So 1000 computers will be having private IPs, but at a time out of 1000 computers, it is possible that 50 computers are communicating. So with one public IP, it may not be able to translated over here, right? So it is possible, like here you may have four public IP addresses for one college, right? So that will be done with the use of dynamic NAT. So in dynamic NAT, we are having pool of public IP addresses, and that is what we are sharing it with multiple private IP addresses. The NAT device dynamically assigns available public IP address to private IP address from the pool whenever communication with the internet is initiated. And see, this dynamic NAT, that we use it in large organizations, right? If you have more than 1000 computer in LAN, then obviously here NAT will be dynamic NAT, right? But for small LANs, for example, if I have 5 computers in my company, then here there will be static NAT only. One more category is there. See, third category, that is NAPT, network address port translation. That is also referred as PAT, port address translation. Here see, that translation will happen with respect to port. So here you see, there will be port number, physical port number with all the devices, and with respect to port number, this router will convert this IP and it will communicate over here with the internet. Here I have shown you by IP address, right? That replacement that I have shown you by IP address. But practically, how router will identify which device is forwarding request and to whom that signal will be given over here? So that decision, that will be taken over here by router based on port address. So in third category, see, port address translation that will happen. So it is extension of dynamic NAT. It maps multiple private IP address to single public IP address with the use of unique port numbers. Each internal device is assigned to different port numbers to distinguish its traffic from each other and sharing the same public IP address. So here, with the use of port number, we translate this private to public and public to private at router side, right? So see, this is how three categories are there. And now I think you are having fair enough idea about what is network address translation. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.